إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. The series, The Correct Islamic Aqeedah or Creed. And we're going to have to take some time to cover all of it. That would require patience in your side. But before we begin, we distributed some handouts, and I believe there is a page missing, so let's go over it quickly. The objectives of this series is to enable you to defend your belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from a person who understands his own belief. You cannot defend something which you don't understand. Even so, you believe in it. You have no question about it, but yet you don't understand it. So the purpose of this series is to offer that understanding so that you're able to speak of it, to speak of Tawheed, to speak of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also to clarify and refute any allegations which they may attribute to Islam. And this is something that is very common these days. Islam is the guilty religion in the face of this earth. And we need people who can advocate, but with knowledge and the manner of advocacy, both the knowledge and the manner. Basically, we're going to be studying the belief in Allah, the belief in the angels, and with the angels always come the belief in the world of al-jinn, عالم الجن والشياطين and the devils. And also, inshallah, we'll be studying the books, the belief in the previous books and the messengers. And also with the studying of the belief in the messengers, we will explain our aqeedah towards our righteous companions. So we're going to talk about the Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhim as we address and talk about the Rusul, the messengers. And then talking about Al-Qadr, believe in Al-Qadr, and also believe in the hereafter, the six elements of faith. The textbook is called Islamic Creed Series. للدكتور عمر سليمان الأشقر رحمه الله, who passed away this year actually. He is one of the students of الشيخ الألباني and other مشايخ, ما شاء الله. I believe he authored a lot of books, but subhanallah, in my humble opinion, this is his masterpiece. It's six volumes, six books. There are six books. And by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are available in both Arabic and English. Both Arabic and English. They've been translated. Of course, there are other sources. These lectures will be sources. We're recording it, inshallah. It will be available. We'll try to develop some sort of a PowerPoint. And of course, we'll always send you some literature, inshallah. We divided the whole curriculum into six semesters. This is the first semester. Each semester will consist of 10 weeks, 10 Sundays, 10 lectures. And we'll try to cover in each semester one element of that correct Aqeedah series. Today, inshallah, we're beginning the first semester, which is called Introduction to the Series. And bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, we shall cover the followings. Number one, Simat Rajul al-Aqeedah. The characteristics of the person who holds the correct Aqeedah. We're going to mention seven of them, inshallah. And I hope this is what you're striving to possess upon the completion of the series. You want to speak like that person, act like that person. This is the intention behind the series, for you to possess these characteristics. We're going to define the Aqeedah linguistically and technically. The definition of the Aqeedah linguistically and technically. We're going to mention the other correct names with which you can call the Aqeedah, because there are false names which are used to refer to the Aqeedah, but they carry inside them poisons, poisonous names, I call them. One of them is al-falsafa, philosophy, Islamic philosophy. And we'll come to that. The false names for the Aqeedah. Then we're going to talk about the sources of the Aqeedah, where a Muslim gets his Aqeedah from. And that will take us to an important subject, which is Khabarul Ahad. We have something, some issue of debate. We have two types of hadith. Hadith that is mutawatir, meaning in each one of its chain of narration, there is more than three who narrated it. But sometimes we have a hadith which has only one single narrator in one of the chains. Only one person. بسموه خبر الآحاد. The one single report hadith. There is a debate amongst the scholars if this type of hadith can be used in order to speak about the Aqeedah or not, as a source of Aqeedah or not. This is an important subject because there is a debate between the scholars regarding this issue. We're going to mention the views of each party. ونرجح إن شاء الله أن خبر الآحاد يؤخذ به. Then we're going to talk about يعني for the Arabic speaking حجية خبر الآحاد في العقيدة. If you want to write this يعني. المبحث اسمه حجية خبر الآحاد في العقيدة. And then we're going to talk about العلاقة بين العقل والنقل. The relationship between the intellect and the revelation. Because this is the problem which the Ummah has. That you approach issues of aqidah with your aql. حتى يقول لك ربنا عرفوه بالإيه؟ يقول لك ربنا عرفوه بالإيه؟ عندنا في مصر الكلام ده ما تعرفوش الكلام ده. ربنا عرفوه بالإيه؟ بيقول لك ربنا عرفوه بالعقل. Intellect, the human brain, the human intellect and الوحي, the revelation. When do you place your human intellect in your pocket? And when can you use it in relation to the revelation? And finally, inshallah, we're going to talk about the importance of the correct Islamic creed. How important that you learn about this. يا إخوة, يعني سبحان الله, my intention behind this class, hopefully to have brothers who can stand in the pulpit and offer a speech. Hopefully brothers who can share their beliefs with the non-Muslims. That is too. But you know, I came across a beautiful hadith. Hadith Anas رضي الله عنه. والحديث صحيح. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم entered into a room of somebody who is dying, passing away. فقال له, he said to him, كيف تجدك? How are you doing? How do you feel? قال والله يا رسول الله, by Allah, O Messenger of Allah, أخشى ذنوبي أو أخاف ذنوبي وأرجو الله. I'm fearing my sins. I'm afraid of the consequences of my sins, but I'm hoping in the mercy of Allah. الكلام هذا لا يخرج من فم إنسان إلا صاحب عقيدة سليمة صحيحة. That statement will not come from a mouth of somebody at the bed of death, but he holds the correct aqeedah. شوف كلامه, أخشى ذنوبي, أخاف ذنوبي. I'm afraid of my sins. He should have said, and I'm hoping in my good deeds. لا, وأرجو الله. I'm hoping in the mercy of Allah, not in my good deeds. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول له, he says to him, لا يجتمعان في قلب عبد في هذا الموضع إلا أمنه الله مما يخاف وأعطاه ما يرجو. Those two feelings gathering in that particular position in a heart of a Muslim, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will secure him from that which he's afraid of and will give him what he's hoping for. فالعقيدة الصحيحة, possessing the correct عقيدة, will help you will help you when you're laying down in the bed of death and people asking you to say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. You will say it. We're going to close inshallah that course with the subject, the importance of possessing the correct aqidah. As you can tell, we started the course with a motivational kind of information, and we end it with a motivational kind of information so that you can excel in between. Now, for those who are interested in making these classes contribute towards obtaining a bachelor in Islamic studies from a university called Mishkah, they need to let me know, because there are certain requirements that we need to fulfill in order to make this happen for you. So if you are interested, you need to let me know so that I make sure that I'm giving your assignments that are required for this class. And all what is needed that you have, by the way, a high school diploma to join in that university. If you have your high school, that's all you need. And the teachings is in English. And you're going to have to take a special test with each one of these courses. So you need to let me know. For you, just for your information, you're going to have to at least write 2 to 3 essays on these subjects, and I'm going to request them as I go. Also, there will be a final paper that you write, and we'll give you a list of subjects at the end of the class, and then you have to take your final exam. It is designed by the university. You have to take it online, and you have to attend and participate in the class. The grading is 75% for the final exam and 25% for attendance, participation, and research paper. I'm not dismissing anybody who doesn't want that, okay? This class is open for everybody, but those who want to specialize and get some Islamic studies, it helps, bi-idhnillah ta'ala. With this, we want to begin our first class today, Simat Rajul al-Aqidah. But before I begin, any questions? But please, questions regarding what I said. Any question? Now. I've given you some list, some...
6 volumes, is it available in the town?
Yeah, you will find it, inshallah. Any other questions regarding what we said? طيب. سمات رجل العقيدة. The characteristics, the characters of a Muslim who possesses the right aqidah. Introduction to this. Islam is being attacked right and left because of the mispresentation. Let's blame ourselves first of the religion. Nabiullah Yunus, Prophet Yunus, taught us to blame ourselves for our conditions. When he was in the womb of the whale, he said, alayhi salam, La ilaha illa anta subhanak, inni kuntu min al-zalimin. I am the wrongdoer. Stop blaming others. Let's blame ourselves for a change. a mustashriq ya ikhwa, someone who study the religion of Islam, they call them Orientalists or mustashriqeen. But they don't study it in order to help it. They study it in order to fight it. People whom the West pay their tuition, pay their school, pay them a lot of money to study your religion in order to find flaws in it. When he studied Islam, he made that statement. He said, يَا لَهُ مِنْ دِينِ لَوْ أَنَّ لَهُ رِجَالِ. What a religion if it does have men, people who can carry it. Subhanallah, right away when I read this, I came across an author في صحيح البخاري, عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه was sitting down and he had other companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم sitting with him. فقال لجلسائه, he said to them, تمنوا, make a wish. فقال أحدهم, one of them said, أتمنى أن يكون ملء هذا البيت دراهم فأنفقها في سبيل الله. I wish I have this house filled with dirham, silver, so that I will spend it in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other one said, أتمنى أن يكون ملء هذا البيت ذهبا فأنفقه في سبيل الله. I wish I have this house filled with gold so that I can spend it in the cause of Allah. فقال عمر, عمر said, أتمنى أن يكون ملء هذا البيت رجالا من أمثال عبيدة بن الجراح فأستعملهم في طاعة الله. I wish I have this house filled with men the caliber of Abu Ubaidah so that I can use them to work for Allah. Abu Ubaidah, ikhwa, is one of the 10 giving glad tidings of Jannah. Sahih? Abu Ubaidah qala anhu an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam li kulli ummatin amin. وأمين أمتي أبو عبيدة بن الجراح. أبو عبيدة بن الجراح, ابن الجراح. For every ummah, for every nation, there is a trustworthy person. The trustworthy of my ummah is أبو عبيدة ابن الجراح رضي الله عنه. أبو عبيدة was one of the leaders who brought Islam to the greater Syria, Jordan, Palestine, Syria, Lebanon. And he died in Ta'un Amwas. He was one of the people who was killed in the plague of Amwas. Subhanallah. When Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu was dying and they were asking him to appoint somebody, he said, لو كان أبو عبيدة ابن الجراح حيا لاستخلفته. If Abu Ubaidah is alive, Abu Ubaidah died before Umar. Ta'un Amwas happened during the time of the reign of Umar. He's saying, if Abu Ubaidah was alive, لاستخلفته. I have appointed him. فَإِن سَأَلَنِي رَبِّي عَنْهُ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would ask me why I did this, لَقُلْتُ اسْتَخْلَفْتُ أَمِينَ الْأُمَّةِ وَأَمِينَ رَسُولِهِ صلى الله عليه وسلم. يعني I guess you're getting the point. الشاهد يا إخوة, that we need people in this ummah who possess the proper aqeedah in order to defend that religion. And don't think that I'm talking about military here. I'm not talking about militants here. No. Intellect. Nor I'm canceling the militants from Islam either. Jihad exists. But الجهاد الآن جهاد الكلمة, جهاد الحجة. The jihad now is the jihad of the word. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described this type to be a mighty one. وَجَاهِدُهُمْ بِهِ. بِهِ here goes to what? Quran, Surah Al-Furqan. وَجَاهِدُهُمْ بِهِ جِهَادًا كَبِيرًا. A mighty jihad. That you're able to present your religion in a confident manner, in a respectful way, in a way that attract people to it. We compiled 7 characteristics. I'm going to name them, so in case if time doesn't allow, then you are in your own. And that's how we're going to go about it. I'm going to try to rush through it, but you're going to have to go home and do your research. Because remember, we said 10 classes, and in a way we are distributing them fairly. The first characteristic, that person must believe in the Islamic creed, a belief that has no doubt. He is certain about every single thing which being told, which being said. No doubt. إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم لم يرتابوا. احفظ هذه الآية. Memorize this verse when you bring this up. Indeed, the believers are those who believe in Allah and His Messenger, and whatever Allah and His Messenger told us, they never, never doubt it. Never doubt it. That is why I said yesterday, if the Maya got to you about the end of the world being on the 21st of December, you're in big trouble. That means your aqeedah is weak. Say, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Because the aqeedah means done. Things that you tie, place in your heart, never question them after that. Never. إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم لم يرتابوا. Not only this, look at this. They committed their lives, their wealth to that cause. وجاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم في سبيل الله. أولئك هم الصادقون. احفظ هذه الآية. Indeed, the believers are those who believe in Allah and His Messenger, and they never question. Number two, and we're going to come back to this. A Muslim who possesses the correct aqidah always seeks knowledge, always learning, always acquiring the knowledge of the religion, because he realizes that this is a sign of goodness. من يرد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين. حديث عثمان عند البخاري ومسلم. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills goodness for you, He will give you the comprehension of the religion, the understanding of the religion. And the religion begins from here, from the aqidah. You're starting. This is the right start, right here. That characteristic is not over yet. You don't only acquire the knowledge in order to debate and argue and to look like a scholar. No, to implement it in your life. ليس العلم عن كثرة الحفظ ولكن العلم الخشية. Knowledge is not about memorizing so much text. Knowledge is about fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If that knowledge doesn't help you to begin with, there's something wrong with you. We'll go back to this. Number three, that individual utilizes whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him with skills in order to serve the deen. Regardless of who you are, regardless of what you do, you have something special. Use it to serve Islam. It can be Facebook, it can be recording, it can be making DVD, making a CD, it can be giving khutbas, whatever it is, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given to you. If you possess the correct aqeedah, you use this to serve the deen of Allah. وَتَحْمِلْ هَمْ هَذَا الدِّينِ. Ya ikhwa, the problem that we have, a lot of the people worry not about the deen, about the religion, about conveying it to others. Number four, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that بدأ الإسلام غريبا وسيعود غريبا فطوبى للغرباء. Islam emerged to be a strange thing, and time will come again when Islam becomes a strange thing again. القابض على دينه كالقابض على الجمر. The person who is holding fast to his deen is like someone who is holding a piece of fire in his hand. The characteristic of a person who possesses the right creed, that you're steadfast and you help others to be steadfast. Not only you, but you're trying to help others to be steadfast. Hang in there. We can do it. We can make it happen. At times, brothers and sisters in Islam, we need that. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam with Abu Bakr in the cave. The disbelievers are standing right there in front of the cave. Ya Rasul Allah, O Messenger of Allah, لو نظر أحدهم, if any of them looks down, he will see us. ها هو النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يثبت, helping Abu Bakr to be steadfast. يا أبا بكر, ما ظنك باثنين, الله ثالثهما. We need that. If you possess the correct عقيدة, when you see a brother shaky, the dunya got to him, you're supposed to help him out. When Muhammad ibn Nuh was jailed with Ahmad ibn Hanbal, rahimallahu al-jami'a, for the fitna of khalqul Quran, something that we'll explain inshallah as we go. Ahmad ibn Hanbal is a famous imam. The rest of the scholars, they given up. Muhammad ibn Nuh was with him in jail. And he was younger than him. He had lesser knowledge than him. And he says to him, Ya ibn Hanbal, no one cares about what I say or the other say, but they will follow you. If you give up, if you compromise, that means everyone is going to follow you. You better stand firm. Be steadfast. Younger, lesser knowledge, helping Imam al-Sunnah to be steadfast. وابن القيم أن تلاميذه يا إخوة ابن تيمية وتلاميذه يعني يحضرني هذا والله يعني قرأت هذا لابن القيم says sometimes the dunya gets to us, sometimes the fitan of the shubuhat and shahawat invade our hearts, the trials of misconceptions and whims penetrate our hearts, and our iman goes weak. All what we have to do is to come and look at the face of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. Just look at him. Our faith goes up again, steadfast. We need that. Ya ikhwa, Ahlu Sunnah are very rare. People who follow the Sunnah are very rare. ولذلك يقول لك, يعني I want to get off the subject here, that if I know that somebody, predecessor, I don't recall his name, he was in Medina. If I know somebody who follows the Sunnah in Morocco, I'll make sure that I send salam to him because I know he's a loner. I'll make sure loners. بس هذا هو الطريق. Number? A person who possesses the correct aqeedah must be different to the disbelievers, to Ahl al-Bid'ah, to the mushriks. Ya ikhwa, mukhalafatul kafir wajib. Being different to the non-Muslims in the way that we dress, in the way that we eat, in the way that we speak, in the way that we pray. A person who possesses the correct aqidah should not be these days asking, Sheikh, can I have a Christmas tree? Sheikh, can I say Merry Christmas? Sheikh, can I give my neighbor a gift? La. Not even subject, he knows. Number six, a person who possesses the correct aqidah must be intelligent and aware of the time he lives in. علم الواقع. And what type of fitan are going around us? And the conditions of the Muslims. Because at the end of the day, you need to convey that aqidah, that religion to your brothers. Understand what the Muslims are going through. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, right before his death, he made that statement out of this world to Aisha radiallahu anha. Ya Aisha, wal hadith fil Bukhari. O Aisha, لولا حداثة قومك بالإسلام لنقضت البيت وأعدت بناءه على قواعد إبراهيم. Has it been that your people, the Quraysh, are new to Islam, I would have dismantled, took the house down, الكعبة, and rebuild it on the pillars of Ibrahim. For you who are not aware, al-Kaaba now, ya ikhwa, that hijr, that's part of the Kaaba. When the flood took place and the Qurayshi wanted to raise the foundation of the Kaaba, they vowed that they are going to use pure halal money. No money from riba, usury. No money from prostitution. Just halal money. All what they got, built, missing that triangle there. Now Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling Aisha, I would like to rebuild the Kaaba again on the pillars of Ibrahim. But the problem, your people are going to give me fitna. They're going to give me a hard time. شوف, علم الواقع. Know who you're dealing with. Ya ikhwa, we have a problem that the people who teach the religion, they don't understand. There is a disconnect between the audience and the deliverer. We don't want that. Inna minkum lamunaffirin. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, some of you turn people away from the religion, from Islam. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a Bedouin, walks in the masjid. البدوي, الإنسان البدوي هذا إنسان بسيط. A simple person. He lives his life out there in a nomad life. He ended up inside walls. The ground looks like the outside. He decided to urinate. It's the masjid. It's the house of Allah. Look how he treated him, sallallahu alayhi, because he knows. Bedawi. Basit. يقول له ما حملك على هذا. What got you to do this? قال والله يا رسول الله, by Allah, O Messenger of Allah, for me there is no difference between this and outside. وكلامه صحيح, يعني الرجل كلامه مظبوط. If you analyze what he said, he makes sense. لأن مسجد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم did not have carpets. ما كانش فيه rugs. There is no rugs. It's dust, it's sand. The ceilings are straws. خشب محطوط فوق السطح. For him is, there is no big difference. Yani I'm telling you right now, would he have walked in a masjid like this? I don't think he would have done it. He would not. Indifferent. This is. Oh. We need people who understand, ya ikhwa, the needs of the Muslims. لأن at the end of the day, I'm telling you, people are not going to accept from you if they don't like you. Wallahi. الذي. This is the only one. If they do not love you, إذ لم يحبوك, they will not accept your message. ولذلك العالم, the true scholar, يمكن في القلب أولا. يعني في معنى يا إخوة that a lot of us recite but we don't pay attention to. شوف, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about نبي الله يوسف, يوسف, what happened to يوسف؟ الكريم, ابن الكريم, ابن الكريم, ابن الكريم. You cannot find a lineage better than this. A prophet, a son of a prophet, a son of a prophet, a son of a prophet. يوسف ابن يعقوب ابن إسحاق ابن إبراهيم. What happened to him? I don't want to go through the story. His brothers decided to throw him in a well, a caravan that was in Palestine, Palestine. A caravan picked him up and took him to the slave market in Egypt. So here he is, الكريم, ابن الكريم, ابن الكريم, standing in the بسموي slave market, بسموي what they call it, ها, سوق النخاسة, هذا slave market, واقف. وبعدين this man will buy him, come. And then Allah says, look at this. وكذلك مكنا ليوسف في الأرض. And thus we empowered Yusuf in earth. طب you tell me where is the empowerment here? He turned from الكريم, ابن الكريم, ابن الكريم, ابن الكريم, to a slave. Where is the empowerment? This man loved him. He liked him. That is why وقال لامرأتي, وقال الذي اشتراه من مصر لامرأته, don't treat him like a slave. I like this man. أكرمي مثواه. So he was enabled. Those who convey the religion to others must possess that. You must have that. If you don't have that, it's not going to work. It's not going to work. Yusuf will not, would not have been the minister or the second man in command would he have not been loved by the people of Egypt. He invaded their hearts first. Everyone who dealt with him loved him. Loved him. وذلك ورد في الإسرائيليات, someone said to him, والله إني لا أحبك. He said, والله, he said, please stop loving me. Every time somebody loves me, I get in trouble. The رجل العقيدة, the man who possesses the correct عقيدة, must be aware. يعني يا إخوة, أنا أعجب والله لهذا, يعني خاصة مع المخالف, especially with those who are disobedient. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في حديث أبي أمامة الباهلي عند أحمد, here he is sitting with his companions And this young man comes in, Ya Rasul Allah, O Messenger of Allah, إِذَلْ لِي بِالزِّنَا. Give me permission to commit adultery. Can you imagine that? الصحابة كلام أدنو تعال come closer شوف أترضى هذا لأمك. Would you like someone to do this with your mother? Your daughter, your sister, خالتك, عمتك, your aunt. لا يا رسول الله ولا الناس. قال يا رسول الله ادعو لي. شايف حول تحول تحول المخالف. Oh messenger of Allah make dua for me please. اللهم طهر قلبه واغفر ذنبه وحصن فرجه. Oh Allah forgive his sin, purify his heart, make him chaste. يقسم هذا الشاب, this young man swears by Allah, after this dua I never even thought about this again. هذا هو الرجل العقيدة تفهم. طيب number 7 and last, لا 7 total 7. Who said 8? Alright, 7. You are certain اليقين بأن المستقبل للإسلام. You must be certain that the future is for Islam. هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent his messenger with the true religion, with the guidance to make it rise over any other faith in the face of this earth. يا إخوة ليبلغن هذا الأمر. حديث تميم الداري في السنن, ما بلغ الليل والنهار. This religion will reach as far as the light of the day and the darkness of the night reach. وليدخلن كل بيت. And Islam will enter every single home, every single house. رجل العقيدة, the man of the عقيدة, is certain, certain about this. Certain about this. You know, we are at a downfall, no doubt about it, the Ummah. But I take you again to the story of Yusuf. You know what happened to Yusuf at the end, right? He became what? The king, the Aziz. Right now, we are in the jub. We are in the pit. Or we are in the dungeon, in the jail. Imagine just looking at the story of Yusuf from that clip only, being in jail, مثلا. لا. Look at the whole thing. Look at the whole thing. وبعدين الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يعلمنا, يعني سبحان الله, يعني ورد هذا في كتب التفسير. When the Muslims were digging the trench, because 10,000 of the disbelievers are coming to attack the Muslims, more than even the inhabitants of Medina. There is no way you can fight those. فسلمان الفارسي decided to suggest this war strategy to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, to dig a trench around Medina ف while they are digging the trench they came across a huge rock عقبة كؤود huge rock inside knock 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 nobody can break it فرايد اواي they called the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم رسول الله تعالى we can't he hits and then you know when the iron meets it makes what sparks الله أكبر فتحت قصور كسرى الله أكبر the palaces of the Persian emperor will be the land of Muslims Muslims will conquer there الله أكبر فتحت قصور الروم الله أكبر The palaces of the Roman Empire is the Muslims now. شوف مش قادرين يقتلوا 10,000 وعمالين يفحتوا في خندق عشان ما يقتلوش بقول لك كسرى والروم. You cannot even fight these guys and you're digging a trench not to fight and you're talking about the palaces of Caesar and the palaces of كسرى. قالوا أن هذه الآية نزلت قل اللهم مالك الملك تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء say Allah is the possessor of kingship he gives it to whomever he wants and takes it away from whomever he wants Just for the record, no one in the face of this earth has hoped for Mubarak to leave office but in a funeral. Subhanallah. Bin Ali, Tunis. Billahi alayk al-ikhwa al-libiyin kuntit al-qadhafi. That's a dream. When sha'Allah al-Asad, his turn is coming. The turn of al-Asad is coming. Ali Abdullah Saleh. شوف Subhanallah. Wallahi ma kunna nahlum. But Allah would not even have dreamt it. But see the power of Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those are the seven characteristics of a man with the proper aqeedah inshallah we'll go back now and go over each one of those individually so what was the first one believe with no doubt I love that now it's easy to say that you believe in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says And the messenger says, with no doubt, but ما مظاهر هذا يعني. This should be reflected in your lives. The first of which, the first sign of this, أن تتحاكم لله ورسوله. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger Become the judge over your life. When you have a problem with your wife, with your children, with your neighbor, with your brother, with your sister, you seek the judgment in the Quran and the Sunnah. You don't try to seek the judgment of the society or even the law if it is contradictory الانسان اللي بيؤمن بهذا الدين يتحاكم اليه الم تر الى الذين يزعمون انهم امنوا بالذي انزل اليك وما انزل من قبلك يريدون ان يتحاكموا الى الطاغوت Don't you see those who claim that they believe with no doubt, like my brother said, and they want to go to Taghut, a judgment that is not according to Allah and His Messenger. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا إِلَى مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ وَإِلَى الرَّسُولِ رَأَيْتَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يَصُدُّونَ عَنْكَ صُدُودًا. Come, let's see what Allah said and what the Messenger said about our differences. The hypocrites will turn away from you. No. We don't want that. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ يَا مُحَمَّدُ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ Nay, by your Lord, O Muhammad, لا يؤمنون. They will never attain iman حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِيمَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ until they appoint you as the judge. Of course, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is dead. Appoint what? Al-an, his sunnah, his teachings as the judge. فيما شجر بينهم ثم لا يجدوا في أنفسهم حرجا مما قضيت ويسلموا تسليما. فالتحاكم. So, ya ikhwa, you must believe, if you truly believe with no doubt, that this religion is complete, is perfect. Perfect religion you have. Perfect. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum. Today I have completed the religion for you. That is why a person who believes with no doubt in the Quran and in the Sunnah never dare introduces something new to the religion. Because the religion is complete. And he knows if he does that, he's truly making a serious statement. الإمام مالك رحمه الله says من أحدث في الإسلام عملا ورآه حسنا. If you introduce anything new to Islam and you think it's good, فقد زعم أن محمدا قد خان الرسالة. Here is the statement that he's making. Muhammad betrayed the message. Because Allah said the religion is what? Complete. Now you're introducing something new. You're saying, Ya Rasulullah, you forgot this one, Ya Rasulullah. You were afraid to say this one, Ya Rasulullah. كلام كفر يستدرك على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. لذلك على المنبر كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. A person who has firm belief in what Allah and His Messenger said with no doubt never encounter or objects the text. One day, يا إخوة في صحيح البخاري, one day عمران بن حصين رضي الله عنهما was narrating this hadith. الحياء كله خير. يعني الحياء, bashfulness, is all good. طبعا في عندنا ناس كثيرة في لما يجي يسأل سؤال يقول لك إيه, يعني a lot of the people when they especially the sisters when they want to ask a question they always I don't know about the Arabic sisters in particular, they say يا شيخ لا حياء في الدين, there is no حياء in the religion. No يا أختي في حياء في الدين. the الإيمان basically the sister is saying, yeah, Sheikh, there is no shyness in religion. Yeah. Yani she's really furnishing, she has a good intention, so she's furnishing the ground that I'm going to ask you about a period or asking about what should I do. يعني سؤال حيجي في ايه في منطقة حساسة يعني, in a sensitive area. فشي's furnishing the ground to ask the question. But she ends up saying, لا حياء في الدين يا شيخ. There is no bashfulness, there is no shyness in religion. يا أخت الدين لا, ده في حياء في الدين. الإيمان, faith is what? بضع وستون, واللفظ الآخر سبعون, حديث أبي هريرة. أعلاها, faith is how many branches? 60 plus or 70 plus branches. The highest branch is لا إله إلا الله. The lowest branch وأدناها إماطة الأذى عن الطريق. والحياء شعبة من شعب الإيمان. And shyness and bashfulness is a branch of إيمان. لا, الأخت تقول إيه؟ ما قالته أم سلمة. قالت إيه أم سلمة؟ إن الله لا يستحي من الحق, هكذا قالت أم المؤمنين. ده اللي المفروض إيه؟ replace this with this. Allah doesn't shy away from the truth. And she asked the question. فعمران ابن حسين was narrating the hadith, الحياء كله خير. فتابعي, his name is بشير ابن كعب. Said to him, ولكننا نقرأ في كتب الحكمة. ما هو ايه عمران بن الحصين is ايه narrating the hadith after the death of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. فstudents of the companions are sitting at me. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, all of حياء is good, shyness all good. So Bashir, one of the audience, imagine one of you to be Bashir ibn Ka'b, said, but we read in the books of wisdom that sometimes it's a sign of weakness. هو فعلا الحياء يعني, people may think that a person who is shy is weak. وبعضها وقار. And some of it, يعني, is a sign of being respectful. Look at the reaction of Imran. والله لا أحدثك. By Allah, I'm done. السلام عليكم. أقول لك قال رسول الله وتقول لي قالت كتب الحكمة. I'm telling you, the messenger of Allah says, and you're telling me the books of wisdom are saying. لا ترد. الآن يا إخوة, people claim that they believe in Allah and His Messenger. They reject what the Messenger said for another person. يعني عبد الله بن المبارك was narrating this hadith, الحديث المعروف. إن الله عز وجل إذا كان الثلث الأخير من الليل تنزل إلى السماء الدنيا. When the final third of the night is here, Allah سبحانه وتعالى descends to the lower heaven. فone of the also the audience said, كيف يتنزل؟ How does he descend? يتنزل كيف يشاء. He descends the way that he wants. Don't ask that question. ودي مسألة, مسائل يعني عقائد يعني ممكن. يعني I'm saying that it is okay actually to explain it to the people. But now Muslims صلي خمسة, why? حجاب, why? لي, why should I do that? الله يا إخوة, I have this, it aches. I have that let's talk about it show, and I get all these young ones calling sometimes. Sheikh, why music is haram? يعني, why I'm supposed to wear my hijab? One of the little girls asking me, why a woman cannot be an imam? For that's a problem, that's a big problem. these kids, if they are brought up with the aqeedah, they will never, you can tell that the aqeedah is not being taught at home. All these are dangerous signs. لأن الأصل في الدين الاستسلام يعني is a submission that you submit. You submit to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. بعدين الأمة ابتليت اليوم يا إخوة سبحان الله seculars فكر. The problem with the seculars, the people who are seculars, they have the ideology of المعتزلة. المعتزلة. We have a sect from the 73 sects in Islam called المعتزلة, أهل الاعتزال. What those people say, they always place the text to their intellect. يعني في عندك حديث في البخاري, في البخاري يقول لك إيه, لا يفلح قوم ولوا أمرهم امرأة. طبعا people now say it's a backward sheikh. You're never gonna win. You're never gonna be victorious if the leader is a feminine. فيقول لك شوف الحديث عادات عادات cultures. If the prophet, look, شوف how he rejects the hadith. If the prophet would have lived until he seen Margaret Thatcher and Golda Meir, he would not have said that. شايف؟ تعرفوا مين مارغريت تاتشر؟ المرأة الحديدية, the iron woman. طبعا يعني كلامهم مردود عليه. في قاعدة عندنا تقول ايه, لا يقاس على شاذ. يعني هذا الكلام, what is the dominant quality of women? Not to be leaders. Now if you get one or two or three being ahead, you cannot use them as, you cannot measure on them. لا يقاس على شاذ. Something abnormal. Some, you try, when you try to come up with a rule, you try to use what? The normal condition. The overall. But when you get one or two or three off the normal, لا ما ينفع, ما تقسش عليهم أبدا. Also يا إخوة, a sign that you believe in Allah and His Messenger with no doubt, that you love His Sunnah and you implement it in your lives, and you don't look at, say, this one is irrelevant and this one is irrelevant and this one is irrelevant, the beard is irrelevant, the this is irrelevant, this is irrelevant, this is قشر ولب, يقول لك this is قشر ولب, this is a skin and this is the heart. لا, it's one package, a package deal. Take it or leave it. أفتؤمنون ببعض الكتاب وتكفرون ببعض. ما ينفع. Also, you should not be narrating a hadith that you know it's weak. Also, يا إخوة, you should attribute yourself to the message. We have a big problem now in the ummah. I'm Ikhwani. I'm Sufi. I'm Salafi. طبعا this worthy of explaining. Listen, Ibn Taymiyyah made a beautiful statement. إن سألوك عن شيخك فقل شيخي رسول الله. If they ask you who is your sheikh, say my sheikh is رسول الله. وإن سألوك عن جماعتك. And if they ask you what kind of a group you belong to, قل جماعة المسلمين. أنا مسلم. طبعا, listen. If you want to serve the deen, the religion, under any banner, that is fine. Go ahead. That is fine. I don't want anybody to misunderstand me here. If you want to serve Islam under the banner of the Ikhwan, that is fine. But let's look at the manhaj. What manhaj do they follow? Under tabligh, what manhaj do they follow? Name any group you want, but what manhaj do you follow? اسمع المنهج هو القرآن والسنة بفهم سلف الأمة. Now say, oh, the sheikh is salafi now. لا لا لا. سلف. سلف means predecessors. And I'm telling you, Salafi is not a group. And if you turn it into a group, Salafi is a methodology to understand the Quran and the Sunnah and implement it. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he spoke about the division of the Ummah, افترقت اليهود, the Jews divided into 71 sects. الحديث في مسند أحمد. The Christians divided into 72 sects. And you Muslims will divide into 73 sects. كلهم في النار إلا واحد. All of them are in hell except one. Which one, O Messenger of Allah? ما أنا اليوم عليه وأصحابي. Those who understand the Quran and the Sunnah the way that I and my companions understand it. This is one hadith. You add to this hadith another hadith. حديث ابن مسعود, عمران بن حسين, عبد الله بن عمرو, عبد الله بن عمر, 10 companions narrated this hadith. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, خير الناس قرني, the best of the ummah is my generation, my sahaba. ثم الذين يلونهم, then the students of the companions. ثم الذين يلونهم, then the students of the students of the companions. We call those Salaf. Hey, we call them what? I'm sorry, the word in Arabic means Salaf. And you know who is the first one who used the word Salaf? Who is the first one who used the word Salaf? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When his daughter died, he buried her and he said, الحقي بسلفك الأول. Join your predecessors. Every person, brothers and sisters in Islam, in closing, in the world right now, Muslims, those 73 sects, all of them, they claim the Quran and the Sunnah. They say Quran and Sunnah, Quran and Sunnah, Quran. حتى الأحمدية, الأمة القديانية, the people that there is a messenger who go to their website. الأحمدية, the people who say that there is a messenger. After Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, they say that we follow the Quran and the Sunnah. الأحمدية يقول لك أنا بتتبع القرآن والسنة. كله بيتبع القرآن والسنة. That is why we always say القرآن والسنة بفهم سلف الأمة. This is the saved sect out of those 73. Those who understand the Quran and the Sunnah the way that these three generations understood it and implemented the way that they implemented it. With this, inshallah, we have covered the first one. Next Sunday, inshallah, we'll go over the rest of the seventh. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.